I know Nadja is how you say it in Portuguese. We have a good friend called Nadja, and so I got myself, I know it's a Nadja. And when I go back, I'll probably call her Nadja. And she'll go, no, it was Nadja. Hey, I can't say thank you often or as much.
What he says here, it might have been, I think, it might have been, yeah. It might have been, yeah. But he had a thing for wanting to dedicate, commemorate the life of our family and so forth. And the grotto over here, back this way, is dedicated to our uncle Jack. He built all Pat's house for him.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. And so there's a pet cemetery, which is only Pat would have that.
Which was that?
Right here. Right there.
Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with each one of you. In the waters of baptism, Patrick died with Christ and rose with him to new life. May he now share with Christ eternal glory. The pall is white as a sign of Patrick's human dignity that was given to him when he received baptism, the dignity that we all have as children of God. Paschal candle is lit at baptism. It is where Patrick received the light of Christ to guide him through this world to the next. So we call on the saints of God, come to Patrick's aid. Hasten to meet him, angels of the Lord. Receive Patrick's soul and present him to God, the Almighty Father. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Christ, have mercy. Christ, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Let us pray. O God, to whom mercy and forgiveness belongs, hear our prayers on behalf of your servant Patrick, whom you have called out of this world, and because he put his hope and trust in you, command that he be carried safely home to heaven and come to enjoy your eternal reward. We ask this for our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever. Shepherd me, O God, beyond my wants, beyond my fears, from death into life. Shepherd me, O God, beyond my wants, beyond my fears, from death into life. God is my shepherd, so nothing shall I want. I rest in the meadows of faithfulness and love. I walk by the quiet waters of your peace. Shepherd me, O God, beyond my wants, beyond my fears, from death into life. Gently you raised me and healed my weary soul. You led me by pathways of righteousness and truth. My spirit shall sing the music of your name. Shepherd me, O God, beyond my wants, beyond my fears, from death into life. Though I should wander the valley of death, I fear no evil, for you are at my side. My rod and your staff, my comfort and my hope. Shepherd me, O God, beyond my wants, beyond my fears, from death into life. Surely your kindness and mercy follow me all the days of my life. Thank you. Lord Jesus Christ, by your own 3 days in the tomb, you hallowed the graves of all who believe in you, and so made the grave a sign of hope that promises resurrection, even as it claims our mortal bodies. Grant that our brother Patrick may sleep here in peace with you until you awaken him to glory, for you are the resurrection and the life. Then he will see you face to face, and in your light will see light and know the splendor of God, for you live forever and ever.
Amen.
Patrick, may our farewell express our affection for him. May it ease our sadness and strengthen our hope. One day we shall joyfully greet him again, when the love of Christ, which conquers all things, destroys even death itself. Eternal rest grant unto him, O Lord, and let the perpetual light shine upon him. May Patrick's soul and all the souls of the faithfully departed, through the mercy of God, rest in peace. Amen. Before the final blessing, on behalf of the family, they would like to thank the Ortega family and for Israel and Nadia for their compassion and kindness that they've shown during this hard time. And Shalom would like also to say something. And Patrick's mother.
So, I just want to tell everybody, thank you so much for coming to say goodbye to my dad. I know that he knew us in many different ways. He's touched many of our hearts. He's going to be missed. And
brother, and I was his best friend. 38 years ago, we buried our mother. today, we're burying Pat. Even though it's the saddest day of my life, it would be one that he would be happy with because of his children and his friends. This was his life, this 111 acres he wanted to share with whomever and whenever and however. And today, he's doing that. And it's God's plan that he's not here, but he's with God, and God is sharing him with all of us today in a spiritual way that we have to accept. Praise the Lord.